If you're already a subscriber, welcome back. And if you're here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and do press the bell icon on the YouTube app and you will never miss any new videos that we release. On our channel, we have many DIY projects on this topic of friction and their links can be found in the description below. The DIY we will do now is a simple one that shows how ball bearings can make a difference in rolling friction. First, this is what we need to make and these are the parts for the structure. All are PVC plumbing materials. We need one pipe of 50 cm, three pipes of 30 cm and two pipes of 24.5 cm. These pipes are just 3 cm in diameter. We need three T joints, one L joint and two end caps. Now I'll assemble it without any cuts in the video but in fast motion. This way you can see every step. The actual tool required to hammer materials like PVC is called a mallet and it's made of wood. And sometimes it also has a plastic head so that the PVC will not get damaged. But if you're careful, then a regular hammer is good enough, like I'm using. PVC pipes are an excellent material to make things because then you get all the joints that you might need. And the best part is that you might not have to use glue even. And that means you can reuse the parts to make something else later on. There, the structure is ready. Now we have to put a cycle rear sprocket on the pipe. This is why we used a pipe of 3 cm diameter. But as you can see, it's still a bit loose. But you can tighten it by putting a layer of paper tape over it. You can see I did that, but it's still loose. So I'll put another round of tape on it. And now the inside ring of the sprocket seems tight enough. We need 1 meter long strong thread and about 60 cm long bicycle chain. First, let's work on the thread. We have to make a loop on the thread and the loop has to be a wide one so that it can go around the pipe. Now put the chain on the sprocket so that it's equal on both sides and it balances. Take the open end of the thread and put it through the hole and take the other end of the thread with the loop and put it around the leg of the structure. Add the bowl for weighing to the other end of the chain. Bring the bowl down till the point is close to the ground and then tie the open end of the thread to the chain. This will limit motion of the chain. Otherwise, it will keep falling off the sprocket. It should also be free to fall down on the side of the weight bowl, but it should lock if it's rotated towards the thread. Now balance the chain once again, along with the bowl hanging at the top point. Now put a marker there. This way we'll also know where to start the experiment from. Here you can see the full setup from the thread to the chain to the sprocket and the bowl. And then we need some small weights or small objects to check the force of friction. Our setup is ready. Let's start with the experiment. I'm putting a 1 gram weight on the finely balanced system. And as you can see, that was enough to rotate the sprocket. The friction is that little with ball bearings. Now we will remove the sprocket, open it up. You will notice that everything in a sprocket opens clockwise and tightens anti-clockwise. This is called reverse threading. And this is opposite to the way you tighten anything else, including nuts and bolts. Inside sprocket, there is a ratchet system. Don't worry about the word. It just makes the sprocket lock in one direction and it's free in the other direction. The small flag-like parts that fell out with the springs were part of that. We don't need it now. Now assemble the sprocket and put it back in place. Now we will have sliding friction in action because we've removed the ball bearings. Let's see if it increases the friction. Yes, it increased it to about 25 grams worth compared to 1 gram that was earlier. Now let's open it up again and put anything that's made of rubber. I had a rubber piece from which I cut these thin strips. You could also use rubber bands. Put the rubber on both sides of the sprocket, tighten it again and let's try once more. Remember, the rubber here is increasing friction because of the nature of the material as well as the pressure by the side rings of the sprocket when we tighten them. All our small weights could not bring it down. And eventually it took 325 grams to bring it down. So you'll see that friction increased by more than 325 times as compared to the friction with ball bearings. That's why the world uses ball bearings for almost everything that's rotating.